What's up everybody, I'm Bulkan playing Fishing Planet, going after another unique fish. This time it's the walleye at Saint-Croix Lake, Michigan. Please check the timestamps for the part you're interested in. No need to watch the whole thing. I wanna catch me some unique walleye and I'm gonna start with the hours first. I tried different weathers, different hours, and I'm gonna share with you guys what works best for me, but that doesn't mean these are the only hours. If you have anything you wanna add, please do in the comment section. This way we can expand and have more information on what hours are actually good. I'm fishing one spot only, so that could also be a factor, but the hours and the weathers that worked for me are the partly cloudy and cloudy day. So on a partly cloudy, after 1 o'clock till 5 o'clock, 4 hours, and I can catch a unique in any of these 4 hours and I can replicate that. So in my mind, these are nice good 4 hours, with the best 2 hours being the first two between 1 and 3. If I start at 1 o'clock till 3 o'clock, I know for sure I'm gonna end up catching at least one unique. So between 1 and 5, first 4 hours, then at the very end of the last couple hours, sometimes I get it, but most of the time I don't. So it's possible to catch some uniques, but for me it's not working as well. Over here on a cloudy day, between 9 and 10, that particular hour works very well for me. Now the Uber sheet also mentions the 8 o'clock, after 8 o'clock, between 8 and 10 basically. But I cannot catch it between 8 and 9, man. I tried several times. If you guys get it, let me know. And then again, the last couple hours are also good, but I'm gonna say this again, the first 2 hours here between 1 and 3 o'clock on a partly cloudy, best hours for the walleye. I like to catch the unique walleye on 2 lures, plastic worm and medium spoon. For the medium spoon, I'm using this setup, and I know it's a little bit too much because I'm not gonna catch a bigger fish than 9 kilograms. This one in particular has got a test line of 18.1 kilogram, not necessary at all, but what I care about is my rod. I can cast between 18 and 56 gram of lure, so this is what I care about. I'm not gonna catch a bigger fish than 9 kilograms, so any line with 9 kilogram and up becomes too much in this particular case, but use whatever you have, guys. I like this spoon in particular, a red tiger, hook size 4 on it, 42 grams. There are variations of it. There is a bigger one that's a little lighter, 24 gram, hook size 6 on it. The difference I see is I'll catch bigger fish on it but less fish, so it's a trade-off. In general, less count but bigger fish. And that's pretty much it on the spoons. There might be other spoons that worked before and I tried them again, but not as good. So red tiger does it. Now over here I have a three-way rig, and I was excited to try the rigs. That was a new thing to me, going for the walleye. Very highly customizable, the rigs. I can use different weights, different hook sizes, and it's really nice because I can really tailor it towards my setup. In this case, I have a jig winner 270. It can cast between 4 and 18 grams, so I put a sinker of 14 gram, hook size offset hook of 4, and a worm 15 centimeter purple. So I don't really touch the length on the leader over here. And I tried all three rigs, and to be honest with you guys, for the walleye I didn't see much of a difference. I suspect going after other fish with different lures, it might be different, but in this particular case, these two, the Carolina rig and the Texas rig, work very well with worms, and it says it in their description over here and over here where it was the other one. Plastic, blah blah, plastic worm. And the last one, it just says that it's really good with predator fish like trout, pike, bass, which walleye is a predator fish. So again, I tried them all on partly cloudy between 1 and 3 o'clock, and they all performed the same, about 12 to 15 fish and 6,000 worth money. So I also tried some jig heads. With the jig heads, Man, I don't think it's better. I think actually it's worse. So if you're trying to use the worm guys, I suggest you go with any of the rigs. But if you don't have them and you have a jig head with you, it's still gonna work. So anything with hook size 4 or 6 on it will do the job. The spot I like fishing is here at the from dawn till dusk over this here. And I'm just gonna walk up to the edge, cast it to the right of this floating thingy in the water as far as I can. Right now I have the medium spoon 42 gram in it. The way I like to do it is both with the spoon and the worm, I'll let it sink on the bottom. You don't have to. It also works if you don't let it sink, but I'm trying to keep it somewhere in the bottom third of the water. So I'll let it sink and then I will do stop and go at the very bottom of it. It doesn't even lift in the beginning, but it still works for some reason. So whatever, you go stop and go. Eventually there will be a fishy, a bite, and I'll get a nice good juicy walleye on it. There you go, boom. First one in. The walleye pulls downwards, you can tell. But other fish I can catch over here, Atlantic salmon, smallmouth bass, and brook trout and tiger trout on the spoon. Let's see what I got. It's a trophy, nice good trophy walleye. Oh, it takes a little longer to sink with this, but oh well, it's still worth it. I like the rigs. After it hits the bottom, I'm gonna start doing the stop and go. Oh, here you go, that's a nice one. My setup is 5.5 kilograms, so if you have a better setup, it's gonna take way less time. It's gonna be much faster. It's just in my case, this works. Let's see. Nice chubby guy, 7.5. They get bigger than that, but I also got bonus experience on it just because you saw the fight kind of went for a little bit longer. But nice good money, 1500. What a nice good round number. So that's it, guys. This is where I catch the unique walleye, and this is where I always end up catching between 1 and 3 o'clock using spoon or worm. Good luck to you. I'm Bulkan. Cheers and take care.